Hello and welcome back to Hiveswap, where we are about to engage in combat with this long snake boy. And this funky beat. If the game just loads. Yes, here we go. Strife. Guess she didn't want the crosshair because that's like a gun thing. Anyway, look at this boy. You've got no chance of beating this thing. You're gonna get way. Step on it. Like this. Too precious to weaponize. Let's beat this thing. Pirouette and bop. Luck next time. Gotta hand it to you. Pox? Time to slam. Slam slunk. Let's do lunch. Peace treat E. Condition untreatable. Snake for the memories. Let's slap this boy. Shuffle and scoot. Hot steppin'. Snake for the memories. Lego of the past. You've got no chance of beating this thing. That's... What's the taps? All tapped out. Snakes for the memories. Lego of the past. Pirouette and bop. Red luck next time. Let's do lunch. Check please. This is so great. Anyway, let's abscond. Graceful abscond. Prima abscond, yo. And there's light. Power back on. You're doing orb psyops of encroaching forces. Over. Give you back light only to snatch it away. Described hypothetical very cruel. Dealing with sick operators, over. No, it was just me. Criminy, Jude. That snake monster is down in the basement, by the way. I managed to get past him, but we'll probably need to deal with that at some point. Second encounter with said serpent, correct? Beast Wily. But sister already established superior wiliness attribute, over. Hey, thanks. I think. Trophy room should be trivial obstacle, over. Wait, what? Attic key, Joey. Eyes on the prize, keep me in the loop, over and out. Alright. Back to... the... there it is. The trophy room. There he is. Same dude. Strife! So this is what was blocking the door. Looks hungry. Pork. Passion orange guava. Better luck next time. Ow. Heirloom? Too precious to weaponize. Ken. Light on your feet. Light bite. Jaw ready for this? Let's tap dance for this boy. Tapetizer. Main roars. Biter luck next time. Can't abscond past him. Please excuse me. Plie. Shoot a tango. Choose your battles. Yikes. Anyway, let's throw this thing at him. Opening course. Fletcherize on the prize. Aw, he enjoyed the pet treat. Maybe you don't need to fight him after all. Yeah, throw another pet treat. Anyone for seconds? Nom nom nom. Make mine a double. There he goes. Goodbye. Treat to a pulp. Alright, monster inflicted death scene averted. You are unbelievably stressed out right now. Congratulations, you have ascended to rank 2. Attained rank of tail wagging tyro. Max HP increased by 12. Muscle increased by 7. Congratulations, you've ascended to rank 3. Attained rank of minute mammal mender. Dexterity increased by 2. Grace increased by 6. Leverage increased by 5. Congratulations, you've ascended to rank 4. Attained rank of peppy patterer. Mastered noggin bob. Hubris increased by 4. Courtesy decreased by 2. So, where's the key? In his desk or something? Would never leave critical item in such obvious location. Over. Okay, but like, where did you leave it? I just had to lure a hungry monster out of here with treats, and I'm not sure how much time I have for brother-sister conspiracy capers before it comes back. If room compromised, can't discuss countermeasures over unsecured line. Utilize puzzler skill set. Over. Ugh, fine. Call back in assistance if assistance required. Over and out. Okie dokie, let's look at this globe. Your past love of globes knows no bounds, but you don't recognize any of the continents on this one. You'd have a better idea of what you were looking at if you could read these scribbly labels, all you can make sense of is the X mark. Could it indicate treasure? Spin! Whee! There was the X. The globe and watch the white beams rake across the surface of the globe. It stopped at 1111 and has been as long as you can remember. Could fix it, but why bother? It's not like you're going to make a habit out of strolling over to the worst room in your house to check the time. This is a katana. You have no idea what to do with one. Wait! Maybe you will just throw it away. This is exactly the kind of thing you wish wasn't in your house. Why couldn't your pa just leave their regular eyes in, and also, more importantly, leave their head attached to their body? You'd like to put something in those sockets, but what? And also, wait, why do you want to do this so much? That's weird. Oh, blip. Look. Seems like someone sliced this big fella's hand off. Unlucky he's a lefty. Lucky he's a lefty, at least posthumously. Equip armor. It's a little out of season. Okay, your loss. Look at this painting. You've never been entirely clear on what's going on in this tapestry, but it certainly looks intense. Just look at that fire-breathing serpent piece at the bottom, and that red-eyed figure on the throne. What's their deal? I don't know, but it is freaky. Anyway, let's look at Horus. This is, Horus, you think? You're not up on your Egyptology. And here we are, it's an Alebrige. I absolutely did not pronounce that right, probably. A folk art monster from Oaxaca, Mexico, carved out of the wood of the copal tree. This little thing used to creep you out really bad until your babysitter suggested you learn more about it. You found out that they are based on monsters an artist saw in his dreams, and ever since then he seemed a lot more friendly. You've got some really old ashes in here and a couple nearly disintegrated hunks of charred wood. As if being dead weren't bad enough, your pa replaced his eyes with some creepy glass orbs. Slight refracted in their faceted stare gives you the creeps. But are you crazy or is there some light reflecting off his antler too? Maybe it bears closer examination. Let's look at the antler, I guess? Something odd about the antlers. Can't quite put a finger on it, or can you? Maybe in literal sense? Pull the antler. Whoa, there, showed it was something. Jude, I can't make heads or tails of this thing. What thing? Over. I turned on the laser, but that's it. Nothing else is happening. Thought you were a puzzle master. Was wrong, it seems. Over. Hold on. Over. Believe this calls for... burns. McGruff Crime Dog experiences trouble? Unbelievable. Over. Wait. Disregard previous burn. Superior burn formulated. Ace Ventura, pet detective. Please respond if ice required. Over. But pfft, nice try. Nice try, dork. Maybe if you were a real tactician, you'd manage to get your burns out on the first try instead of requesting do-overs. Pride wounded, but unable to protest. Have been informed mildly contentious banter, cornerstone of squad camaraderie. Over. Yeah, anyway. How am I supposed to solve this thing? Is this clearly a puzzle thing that cries out to be solved? Use marbles. Over. I'm thinking as hard as I can. You know I like puzzles. I wouldn't be asking if it weren't an emergency. Actual marbles. Over. What are you talking about? Trivial, really. Over. What marbles? I don't have any marbles.
You don't? None nearby? Over.
No! Oops. Over.
And now we are Jude. Look at this nerd, boy. That's a giant ass treehouse, my guy.
You are now Jude Harley. And though tonight is apparently the night you've been preparing for, laying so many preparations and countermeasures and counter-countermeasures against, it would seem you made a rare tactical blunder. The marbles that Joey needs to disengage your strategic defense globe are here in your treehouse. Time to call in the lone gunbirds. Here are they, by the way, the lone gunbirds. When the heat is on from the government and you need to send an encrypted message for staying off the grid, you entrust it to one of your trained carrier pigeons, the lone gunbirds. You survey the troops. They're Slangly, Bias, and of course Frohike. He's your favorite. Dear sweet Frohike, how you adore him. You cherish the wind he flaps. I'm gonna take a drink. I'm still in my first recording session and I've already talked for 1 hour straight, so my throat's a bit hoarse, you could say. Let's look at this stuff. Your careful records of the activity of the mysterious figures you often see prowling around in the woods. Joey didn't buy it, but the sudden influx of monsters may have changed her stance. Your tactical escape hatch allows ingress and egress from your amazing treehouse. Let's egress. Oh. Let's try that again. Look, if it were just your can on the line, you'd be out that hatch down the ladder and blasting monsters in a second. But Joey's counting on you and you've got to get her to a more defensible position before you can even consider heroically abandoning your own. Look, the perfect place to store your flares. Well, some of them. It's also where you keep your beeper, but you really don't want to get into that right now. Let's open that thing. You retrieve the cache of flares you were keeping in your metal chest. Combined with your flare gun, they are a tactical treasure.
Tactical error. Consolidated all marbles here in treehouse to prevent attic key from falling into wrong hands. Over. Additionally, forgot about doing that. Over. No cause for concern. Putting top agent on it. Over. Wait, who? Did you get in touch with one of your friends or... Oh god. You mean one of your pigeons, don't you? Over and out. Only a few of these are actually liquids, and unfortunately, those are also the ones whose contents you don't precisely exactly 100% remember with total certainty. You're not saying some of them are urine, but you're not saying none of them are urine. You keep smashing geodes in case they are secretly alien eggs. And if one is, well, you already have the hammer in your hand, won't you? Floop. What even is that? Put that away. What is going on here? President Clinton gives birth to Bigfoot. Bad boy spotted at bar mitzvah. This thing, talk about an enigma. One day you figure out what it does and why certain shady characters want to get their hands on it so badly. We have some theories, of course. Your copious notes on some disreputable activities carried out by members of what you can only describe as some sort of cult. You've been surreptitiously gathering intelligence on them for a good while. You've detailed some of this stuff on your sites, but the really juicy stuff has to stay off the grid. A term you have just coined yourself, just now. Okay, let's get also the flare gun, because why not? You're probably the only kid in school that owns one of these babies. What if those kids get stranded in the middle of the ocean? Then jokes on them, until they starve and die. It's a quibbit. The chamber is empty because you observe proper flare gun safety protocols, but maybe you should load it because you've also observed some scary stuff this evening. Let's combine these things. Breath held, hands steady, you carefully load the flares into the flare gun. There's no going back now. The genie is out of the bottle. Yeah, let's look at this and figure out this puzzle. We need one red and one green marble. Red, green. Red on the right, green on the left. You've already committed this crucial intelligence to memory, but a truly great field commander keeps even better records. Alright, let's put a red marble. You put a red marble in the pouch and a green marble. A green marble in the pouch. This stuff is all treasure, plain and simple. And let's get the pouch. Get pouch. You take the pouch with red and green marbles. Ooh! And let's give this pouch to a pigeon. Here we go. Go! Oh! Oh no! The fuck? No! Ah! Sorry for hold up unbelievable tragic disaster, over. Did you lose something else? Must soldier on making second attempt now, over. Alright, are you sure you're over? Over and out, throw hike. Rip throw hike. You were the best of us, you were the worst of us, but mostly the best of us. Let's send another one. Here we go. Yeah. Oh. Oh. Are you alright? Betrayal, over. Abandonment, over. The lowest, vilest cowardice, over. Well... Can't even communicate true degree of outrage, over. Likely to jeopardize mission if emotion not suppressed, over. Incoming, over and out. Okay, here we go, last try. Are definitely not shaking as you pluck two more marbles from the safe, cozy compartment in the drawer and drop them into the depths of the pouch's waiting leathery maw.
Here we go, bias. Go on, bias. He's in. Yes! Bias made it.
Success! Jesus, Crow Bias, my boy, so brave, so true, so great. Over.
Are you actually just point blank losing your mind now? It would maybe be kind of a relief after years of build up, but you could have picked a better night for it.
Mission accomplished! Bias, champion of champions, waiting for you in kitchen. Over.
Why?
Over. Oh, Bias has marbles required to acquire key. Over.
Alright, I guess that sort of makes sense.
New development, Bias being menaced. Please hurry. Over.
Wait, what? What? Okay, I'm on it.
Hurry, please, Joey. He's all I have left. Over and out.
Okay, here we go. To the rescue for Bias. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, funky music. Brr. Ooh, strife. Well, first we need that actually. Yoink. Got magic spice mix. I forgot to pick that up the first time we were here. Yen, do you hear me? No time for this. Jesus Christ. Let's alert him, maybe. Pardon me, boy. Can you give me a shine? Oh. Thrill him with daylight. And now, spice it up. Spice to meet you. Jesus. He just flipped his shit. Mixed success. We did it.
Joey, thank you for tactically brilliant seasonings murder. Bias has payload, repeat. Bias has payload, over.
Thanks, do you know how I might get him down? He seems pretty terrified.
Negative, Bias simply has unfortunate mercenary streak. Should respond to enticement, over.
How do you bribe a pigeon?
Sounds like set up for riddle or perhaps joke, over.
Bye, Jude.
Over and out.
Okay, now we have a dead monster in our kitchen, but also...
Let's get in here.
And... we got it. All you can rate from this meager cabinet is the stalest, tiniest, worst cracker. But we have the cracker. And let's give it to Bias. Hello, Bias.
Success!
This little fellow, Bias, you think? Yes, you're pretty sure this is Bias. Gobbles down the stale cracker as you tuck him into your pocket. He's got a little parcel around his neck, which you're fine with letting him hold onto until you actually figure out what you're supposed to do with it. Let's look at Bias. This is Bias, apparently. He has a little satchel around his neck. Jude says there's some marbles in there, so you guess those will come in handy, somehow. Until such a situation presents itself, you're content to let Bias handle marbles duty.
Okay, got some marbles. Do you want me to send the pigeon back?
No!
Over.
Okay.
Sorry, didn't mean to shout, just worried. Please protect Bias, his chances of surviving return trip very remote. Over.
Okay, yeah, good point. Seems pretty dicey out there.
Affirmative. Over. I'll just use the marbles or whatever then. I'll let you know how it goes.
Affirmative. Good luck, sis. Over and out.
Alright, let's use Bias with some stuff. Bias picks the treat up with his beak and after a moment spits it back into your hand. Evidently, he doesn't care for the taste. Either that, or this bird is literally too dumb to know what food is. Whoop. Aw, that startled the bejesus out of him. Bias gives you a little wink as if to say, one day, sure, when you're ready.
Wow, talk about fresh!
Also, we can try this. The world's just not ready yet. Just as it. Spicy Bias?
What? No, no! Bias is not a snack!
He's probably going to try to eat them, right? That's what he'll do, because he's a simple little bird brain who... Okay, so he's wearing the pork like a little hat? Touché, Bias. That's pretty darn cute. Heirloom? Bias is a cutie, but you're not quite sure you want to entrust your shiny treasured memory of your dearly departed mother to an animal with a fascination for shiny objects and a proclivity for flying out of reach. Alright, so we have the marbles. Let's get back to the trophy room. Also, have we looked at these masks? These should probably be in the museum. That's all we have to say about this. Oh, also what we didn't look at, this thing. Wow. This, whatever this is, depicts some heroes conversing with huge monsters. Do the monsters help them? Kill them? You prefer to imagine everybody gets out okay. But you know life is really that kind. You got nothing. You feel unqualified to comment. Yeah, same. So, let's try the marble. Like this. You carefully remove the marble pouch from around his neck, and believe it or not, shove the marbles into the empty eye sockets. You discard the pouch. What an evening it's been. And let's spin this darn thing. Schlup, that is. We've covered the key. You did it. The attic key has been found. Take it. You got what you assume to be the attic key. Ooh, you're making progress. Got the key. Heading back up to the attic now. Careful, may not be that simple. Over. What do you mean? None of this has been simple. It's been downright convoluted. Noticing hostile elements grouping serpents massing over. Oh jeez. We'll try to back you up if possible. Remain alert, sis. Over. Always am, bro. Over and out. Here we go. Ooh. Oh. Whoa. Yikes. Well, you've been in tough spots before, right? Hey, wait. Ooh. Knockout. Now we have to switch to Jude and shoot a flare at them. Pew! Pew pew! Pew! Let's beat someone. Excuse me. Fucking rip. No excuses. Now would be a really great time for Jude to fire another flare. Time for Jude to do a thing. Pew! The stars are nice. Look at the sky. Let's try to make them allow to us by tapping. Putting on the ritz. No vacancy. Maybe. Yeah, we have to shine right again. Hey, jerk! Poof. Delighted to see ya. die leitet. One more time? Maybe? Maybe there's no one to knock out, but let's try. Here we go. Oh, come on, Jude. You had one job. Oh no, your flare gun. Oh! Rip your flare gun. Her? Oh, that's fire. Shit, dude. Whoa. I wanna see. Let me through. What the fuck's going on there? Meanwhile, we skedaddle up, up and away to the attic. Noom. Let's use the key on the attic. And we're in. Check. Oh. Well, rip. Is that a hand?
Joey, come in, please. Report status. Joey, hello. It's Jude. Joey, are you okay? Joey, please. Over. Yes, I'm safe. I'm in the attic. Just barely made it. Phew, over. Locked in, actually. I dropped the key. Safer in attic than rest of house. Key can be retrieved later. Over. I think you were right. The way they smashed through the living room window and the front door. If I'd stayed in my room, I'd be a goner. Separated us with Vanguard. Destabilized power. Probe defenses. Finally attempted entry through multiple points of ingress. Basic siege attacks. Siege tactics. Over. Wow, you were right. I'm impressed. I guess all those conspiracies you're always talking about turned out to be, not fake? Maybe? Too soon to tell for sure, but absolutely certain, correct, and always have been. Over. Anyway, thanks. So I'll just hole up here for now, I guess. Are you safe in the treehouse? Should you try calling your friends or something? Didn't want to risk their involvement. Always a gamble engaging soldiers of fortune. But maybe time. Remain secure in location and ignore object under the curtain. Over. Totally, I'm not going to. Well, obviously I'm not going to ignore it. Joey, please, over. What? That's a big mysterious thing under a beguiling fluttery curtain. I have to at least peek at it. What is it anyway? Data insufficient to determine. Over. Well, I'll let you know what I find out. Joey, don't tactically and pigeon. Over. You there? Over. Jude, can you repeat that? Not so static. Joey, please do. Go. The portal. Did you say portal? Well, and now we are here. Let's look at this hand. Well, it turns out you live in a house that has a hand and a jar in it. You must now carry this knowledge with you. Forever. The world is in crisis. If only Captain Planet were here, then the monsters could eat him and you could escape while they were distracted. And the leg. You put this in the attic yourself because it weirded you out that your pa had a lamp shaped like a woman's leg. Little did you know he'd soon graduate to lamps shaped like entire women. As you do. Another victim of Jude's overzealous crowbarring, no doubt. Any chance he gets to go prying and jimmying, the kid just goes nutso. Look. The handwriting is barely legible and there's no return address, leaving with you no more information than you had before you looked at it. Pick up.
No, this really isn't that kind of mystery. The boring kind where you have to frequently refer to your rigorously maintained collection of shipping invoices in order to make any progress. You hate those. Look. Since he got his first best shotgun, this one fell out of favor and now primarily functioned as a home to a thick layer of attic dust. Meanwhile, its favorite brother is living out a shotgun's daydream in the hands of your pa. Lock load. There is no chance you are going to pick up this gun, and you certainly aren't going to lock and load anytime soon. It just isn't going to happen. Let's walk over here. Let's put this away. This. Ick, more of his guns. These are antiques and would probably fetch a tidy sum at auction. But you think the only real perk to their antiquity is it probably means it's been ages since they were used to murder anything furry and precious. Equip. You don't use guns. These are definitely loaded though. Your pa doesn't leave unloaded guns lying around. Or hanging precariously in decaying nets either. Jeez, this is right above your room. Masks. Disguising your identity and impairing your vision wouldn't really help matters much. You're pretty sure the monsters are going to eat anybody they meet. You haven't been up here in a while. Your pa sure does keep a lot of weird crap up here. Weirder than the other crap, that is. Or maybe not. Maybe all the stupid crap is basically the same. Ick, more of his guns. Yeah, we had those guns. Let's walk over to this ominous thing. Oh. The music stopped. And here, more globes. Why does he love globes so much? Maybe they remind him of adventure. All the little abstract geological features, the jagged borders of exotic nations, the tiny bumps representing mountains. Unfortunately, whenever you look at globes in school or wherever, they just remind you of him. Well, that's sad, maybe. But hey, let's look at this thing. You can't avoid noticing the drape rustling around, although you really wish you could. Better see what's under there now, though, before it gets a drop on you. Let's remove it. Ooh, that's ominous. Oh, that is even more ominous. Look, you have no idea what this is. You don't know where it came from or how long it's been here. Did Jude know about this? Is that why he really sent you to the attic? No, that doesn't make any sense. Did your pa know? It looks kind of different from the stuff he usually dumps off here. Feels different in your mind. At least you. Wait, what? You're having trouble thinking clearly. Trouble keeping your train of thought. How long have you been standing here? Operate. You don't know how to operate this thing. Except, of course, to put a key in it and turn it. That seems like the obvious thing, doesn't it? Like the most obvious and necessary thing you've ever known, and were always going to do, and have always known, and do it. Do it. Do it now. Now! Now! The key! Do it! Do it! Open the door! Jeez. Look. Yeah, well, we had this, yes. Let us use the key, I guess. Yes, definitely, yes, jeez, wow, yes, you... Okay, yeah, you want to do that, just, yeah, the keyhole, do it, you feel like you have to. Ooh. Oh. Um Yikes. F-swap. Well, here we are. And we have a new UI, which is fancy. Also, our flashlight is on, and I think we will continue this in the next episode. But before we go, let me show you the save variant, because you can actually save like this and name your own save, which is nice. No? Let's say, gosh, how to name this? Let's call this save return to sender. Please. There we go. And I will see you next time. Until then.